this video, we will study about the operator algebra. It means what are the operators and what are the different terms related to the operators. This is a very important topic for the CSIR NET exams because several questions, several numericals comes related to the operators. So firstly, we see what are the operators. An operator is a symbol for a certain mathematical operation which will transform one mathematical function into another. It means when we apply the operator on one mathematical function, it will transform this mathematical function into the another mathematical function. And the important thing is that the operator has no meaning when it stands alone. It has meaning only when it comes with the function. An example of the operator is dy dx. It means differentiation. Dy dx is an operator and it has no value when it stands alone. But when we put a function in front of it, it will have a meaning. It means the differentiation of that function. For example, if we put the function x square, then we get d by dx x square, and this means the differentiation of x square, and the differentiation of x square is 2x. So we get a new function. This function is converted into the another function, and this is the meaning of the operator. So dy dx is a operator. Now the important type of an operator is the commuting operator, and several questions comes related to this type of operator. So what are commuting operators? If A and B are two operator and the condition is that the A operator B operator is equal to the B operator A operator, it means when we apply firstly B on the function and then apply A, and it is equal to when we firstly apply A and then apply B and both are equal, we can say that these two operators are the commuting operators. We can understand it with the help of the example. For example, if any operator is A is K and the another operator is dy dx and the function is sin x, and if we apply the first condition, it means when we firstly operate this function with B and then with the A, it means k dy dx sin x, then we get the result, the differentiation of sin x is cos x. So we get the result is equal to k cos x. And if we apply the second condition, it means when we firstly operate it with the A and then with the B, and the result is dy dx k sin x. If we solve this, we get the value is same, that is k cos x. It means in both the conditions we are getting the same result. So we can say that AB is equal to BA. It means these two operators are commuting operators. Another term is the commutators. What are commutators? If A and B are the two operators, then it is possible to construct a new operator, and it is denoted by this sign, and this is known as the commutator of the two operators, and it is denoted by this symbol. So the commutator will be equal to AB minus BA operator, and it will be equal to A operator B operator minus B operator A operator. For example, if the two operators commute, then their commutator will be equal to this, and this will be equal to this, and this will be 0. So this commutator stands for the multiplication with the 0. Now we see the linear operator. If A is an operator and it is acting on the sum of two functions, the sum of these two functions, the one function is fx and the another function is gx, and it is acting on the sum of these two functions. It means the condition is that the A operating on the sum of these two functions is equal to the sum of A operating on these two functions separately. It means a fx plus a gx, and both are equal, then the operator is known as the linear operator. The example of this type of operator is the dy dx. Dy dx is a linear operator. How we can prove it? Let we see if the operator is dy dx. And the first function is x cube, and the another function is sin x. Now the first condition on the left hand side, we can show it a fx plus gx. Then we put the values in this. So operator is dy dx, fx is x cube, and gx is sin x. So the equation becomes dy dx x cube plus sin x. By differentiating this, we get the differentiation of x cube will be 3x square, while the differentiation of sin x will be cos x. So we get the value 3x square plus cos x. Now on the right hand side, we have written both the functions separately. It means the operator A is acting on both the functions separately. So when we put in this the values, we get dy dx x cube plus dy dx sin x. And when we differentiate them separately, we get differentiation of it get 3x square, and the differentiation of it get cos x. So we get the value 3x square plus cos x. So we can see both the values are same. It means the left hand side is equal to the right hand side. So dy dx is a linear operator. Next is the vector operator. So vector operator is a differential operator, and it is defined in the Cartesian coordinate, as it is a directional operator and it is denoted by this symbol. So the vector operator is equal to I del upon del x plus j del upon del y plus k del upon del z, where I, j and k are the unit vectors in the x, y and z directions respectively. An example of the vector operator is the Laplacian operator that is used in the Schrodinger wave equation. The next and the important type of operator is the Hermitian operator. What is the condition for this operator? When an operator satisfies this condition, then it is known as the Hermitian operator. What is the condition? The integration of psi 1 star a psi 2 d tau is equal to the integration of psi 2 a psi 1 star d tau. It means the operator acting on this function and then multiplied with this and then integrated is equal to the operator functioning on this function first and then multiplied with this function and then integrated, and both are equal, then it is the Hermitian operator. Actually, Hermitian operator is a linear operator. An example of Hermitian operator is d square upon dx square. We can prove this, that the d square upon dx square is a Hermitian operator. If we take the operator is this, and the first wave function is exponent of ix, and the another wave function is cos x. And when we apply the first condition, it means this left hand side condition, we use this and we put the values of all of these, then we get integration of exponent ix d square upon dx square cos x dx. And by solving this, integrating this, we get minus integration of exponent minus ix cos x dx. This becomes the left hand side equation. Now if we take the right hand side condition and we put the values in this, we get an equation like this. That is minus integration of cos x d square upon dx square exponent ix dx. And if we solve this equation and we get the same equation as that the equation 1, It means the left hand side and the right hand side both are equal. So this operator is the Hermitian operator. If we see the properties of the Hermitian operator, the first property is that the eigenvalue of the Hermitian operators are real. And the second is that the eigenfunction of Hermitian operator with different eigenvalues are orthogonal. It means if this is an operator, that is Hermitian operator, and these are two eigenfunctions and both have different eigenvalues. It means this has lambda 1 and this has the eigenvalue lambda 2. Then the both eigenfunctions will be orthogonal. It means psi 1 and psi 2 are orthogonal. That means the integration of psi 1 star psi 2 dto will be equal to 0. Now we start an important term, that is the eigenfunction and eigenvalues. What are eigenfunction and what is eigenvalue? If an operator act on a well-behaved wave function, what is a well-behaved wave function? We have cleared it in first video. A well-behaved wave function means when it has a finite value, single valued and continuous, then it is called a well-behaved wave function. So when an operator acts on a well-behaved function and it generates the same wave function multiplied by a constant, then constant is known as the eigenvalue and this wave function is known as the eigenfunction. This is the equation that denotes this. A psi is equal to E psi. This equation is known as the eigenvalue eigenfunction equation. In this equation, this is the operator and this is functioning on, this is acting on this. So this is the eigenfunction that is denoted by psi. And when this is acting on this and it generates the same wave function and this is a constant value E, this is called the eigenvalue. So this is eigenvalue, this is eigenfunction and this is the operator. We can understand it with the help of the example. Suppose this is the example, this is an operator d square upon dx square and it is acting on this wave function sin mx. Then when we solve this, we get this value and we differentiate it again, then we get minus m square sin mx. So we are getting the same wave function here. So it is called the eigenfunction and this constant value that is we getting is known as the eigenvalue. So this is eigenfunction and this is eigenvalue. Next term is the normalized wave function. What is normalized wave function? When the condition is that the integration of psi I star dto is equal to 1. It means any wave function and its complex conjugate and its integration is equal to 1. Then such wave function is known as the normalized wave function. Any wave function can be normalized by multiplying it with the constant. This constant is known as the normalization constant. So if psi is a wave function, normal wave function, and c is a normalization constant, so we can multiply this psi with the c and then the result c psi will be the normalized wave function. The next term is the orthogonal wave function. If the two wave functions are psi 1 and psi 2 and the condition is that if we integrate psi 1 star psi 2 dto or we integrate psi 1 psi 2 star dto, both are equal and in both the condition we get a result 0. Both integrations are equal to 0. So such type of wave functions are known as the orthogonal wave function. If we take psi 1 equal to sin x and psi 2 equal to cos x and we integrate in the limits 2 pi to 0, then it will be 2 pi to 0 limits sin x cos x dx. Now we multiply and divide by 2 and the equation like this is formed. As you know, the value of 2 sin x cos x is sin 2x. So this type of equation is formed and integrating this we get this type of equation. The value of cos 4 pi is 1, while the value of cos 0 is also 1. So the net result is 0. It means these two functions are orthogonal wave functions. Is the orthonormal eigenfunctions when psi 1, psi 2, psi 3 are different eigenfunctions such that each of them is normalized. It means integration of psi I star psi I d to is equal to 1, and any of these eigenfunction is fulfilling this type of equation, this condition, then this will be normalized wave function. And any of these two functions are also orthogonal, it means they are fulfilling this condition. It means integration of psi I star psi j d tau is equal to 0. There psi I is any of this wave function, it means psi 1, and psi j may be psi 2 or psi 3. So any two different wave functions are also fulfilling the condition of orthogonality. Then such type of wave function are known as the orthonormal wave functions. So this is all about the different type of operators, eigenvalues, eigenfunctions, and all the terms of this type. If you like this video, please share this, please comment us. In our next video, we will understand about the particle in one dimensional box problem. Thank you.